Matter of fact, hey, just for 2 seconds, I would like you to share just for 1 minute or a couple minutes about your son's conversation with some barristers up there in Canada. What he shared with what you shared with me before when he was sharing about the bond information with those guys.
Oh yeah, my son went to a Christmas party, and he has a friend of his that became a lawyer, and he was there with a criminal lawyer. His friend's a real estate lawyer, so there was a couple of lawyers there at the table, and the criminal lawyer was discussing a case that he had this this guy that was a drug dealer, and he couldn't draft him for performance, so he was trying to get his girlfriend in, and they were discussing how he was going to do it. Says, if we get the girlfriend in, then maybe he'll talk. So my son thought that was, like, pretty nasty to do. So he asked the guy straight up. He goes, well, which one are you trying to get in, her legal person or her as the woman? And he looked at him, and he said, who is this guy, to his friend? He said, he's pretty smart, so you better watch what you're talking about in front of him. So he said, well, isn't it all about the bond? And he told him about the bid bond, performance bond, the payment bond. The guy's mouth dropped. He said, you're not supposed to know this stuff. He goes, where'd you get this information from? And he said, I just want to ask you a question. How the F do you sleep at night?
That's right.
He said, how do you go to sleep knowing what you're doing to us? He goes, because I don't know. He goes, I wouldn't be able to sleep. And they just shut right up, and he knew right then and there that it was definitely about the bond. So he came home, and he said, it is definitely about the bond. He said, I'm not supposed to know this stuff. And he said, well, knowledge is power. And the guy didn't say one word to him. He said, yeah, but that's too much knowledge.
Yeah, that's right. They don't want the sheep waking up and actually knowing it. Folks, like I say, it's all about a hypothecation event, and that's why we're starting at the very beginning. This is so beautiful because this is going to give everybody a lot more clarity on the game, and that's all it is, a game, a money game, on them to exhaust everybody's beneficial interests and rape the estates because they think you don't know who you are, and if you're operating in the dead capacity, you don't. That's beautiful. Thank you, Terry, for sharing that. That was beautiful.
No problem.
Anyways, hey, folks, here's some more irrevocable proof. Matter of fact, Sister Deatra, she had a little showed him a little love asking for the bonds, and once she knew that the fraud was perpetrated upon the court, she was going to step forward to move to the next level. They didn't want to talk to her ever again. They said, have a nice day. And they had her binded up on a whole different way, folks, and she just wanted to go settle the account and share the love. Well, they didn't want her to know that their hands were caught in the cookie jar. So, folks, we're uncovering the cookie jar on multiple levels. And, you know, like I say, if they had honesty and integrity, and see, that's where I do say settling the account is always going in honor. And, hey, you just want to take care of it. But the concealers don't want us to know this. So that's all right. Anything you want to know about bonds, folks, go to privatist.me. I got all sorts of information on the bond stuff. So thank you so much, Terry, for sharing that. So just in case everybody thinks that there's no trickery, that they're operating in honesty with an integrity, there is no honor in the public. And they're stealing and raping the estates in the private through the corporation. And it's all about the corporations, folks, not about you. It's about hypothecation. So we'll uncover this over the next 8 weeks, and everybody's going to get the memo on a different level.
Hey, Pete.
And, yep.
Pete, you can also share with the listeners about the hazard bond with the if the police would to stop them on the side of the road, and because Jordan's done that too, and it's about that bond too, because they're flying without a net. So you might want to share that story.
Yeah, real quick. Yeah, folks. Basically, anytime a cop gets out of his car, he's operating in full unlimited commercial liability. In other words, if he's in his car, that's his so-called safe zone. Once he steps out and comes into your domain as a private man or woman, he's operating in his full unlimited commercial liability, and you have the right to say, hey, before we can move forward, I'll be glad to give over to you anything you want. As soon as I see a copy of your hazard bond, the name of the underwriter, and I'll need the name of your risk management office with their phone number so I can make a phone call to make sure that you're operating your proper capacity. And then on the same breath, you can ask him to get his boss because you'll need to see his bond too. In most cases, folks, they'll just say have a nice day and send you down the road. But you got to know how to operate, and you got to know how to put it where you're not being adversarial, but you do have the right to ask. This is what I'm saying, folks. They are scared witless when you start having a little bit of knowledge. And I actually have a document. I'll post it to the site on exactly how to handle that. And that will be posted on privacy.me. So yeah, keep a copy of that in your car so you'll know how to operate. You're not going at them. You're not being adversarial, and you're not warring. But you do have the right to know that this guy who wants to draft you for performance is not operating without a net. Just like the DAs who bring the charge, their bond is supposed to be put up for every case because every case is considered a new constructive trust, implied or otherwise. So we cover that over at privatist.me. Won't cover it now because we're getting down to the last 4 minutes of this call.